Hello Warriors, I'm Dr. Akerkar and welcome to this episode of Stand for Ace videos. Do you take tablet Methotrexate for your arthritis, tablet Folitrax, Mexate, Mexed or Oncotrex? Then this video is for you. We are going to discuss the side effects of Methotrexate, how common are they, what are the side effects, what are the early signs, how can you recognize them early, and what are the different treatment modalities, the various tips and tricks to take care of the side effects of Methotrexate. Let's have a look. Methotrexate is one of the most important anti-arthritis medication and is commonly used in multiple types of arthritis like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, spondyloarthritis and SLE or lupus. It is available in different brand names like Folitrax, Mexate, Mexed, Mex 7.5F, Immutrex, Oncotrex. Most of the patients who take Methotrexate do not have any problems or side effects. A vitamin folic acid is always given along with Methotrexate, and this folic acid tends to reduce the side effects related to Methotrexate. Methotrexate is usually given once or twice on two consecutive days every week, and folic acid is given on the other days, generally not given on the day of Methotrexate. One of the most common side effects associated with Methotrexate is nausea or vomiting. The folic acid that is given with Methotrexate generally takes care of the nausea or vomiting. If one has severe nausea or vomiting, what can be done? One, the Methotrexate dose can be split. For example, if someone is taking 15 mg Methotrexate tablet once a week, the dose can be split into 5 mg once on Saturday and 5 mg 2 on Sunday. So splitting the dose can reduce the nausea and vomiting in quite a few individuals. There are multiple anti-emetic medications that reduce the nausea and vomiting that are available. Those medications can be taken on Saturday, Sunday or on the day of Methotrexate to take care of the nausea. One can take the dose after food to reduce the nausea. One can take the dose at bedtime. So you have your dinner, take the Methotrexate dose and just go to bed. So many times this also takes care of the nausea. Though one can have some nausea on the day after the dose of Methotrexate, there have been quite a few studies which have shown that interestingly, increasing the caffeine intake on the day of Methotrexate can reduce the nausea associated with Methotrexate. So if you take Methotrexate on Saturday and Sunday, you can increase your coffee intake on Saturday, Sunday to reduce the nausea. And lastly, if nothing works, if all the things that I've already told don't work, you can consider an injection of Methotrexate. Injectable form or injection of Methotrexate is very much available. And most of the times, it takes care of the nausea that is associated with tablets. Oral ulcers, ulcers in the mouth, are again one of the common side effects of Methotrexate. Folic acid that is given with Methotrexate generally takes care of this. If one still gets oral ulcers, adding a multivitamin tablet generally takes care of these ulcers. Hair loss. Hair loss is something that is associated with Methotrexate. It is not permanent, so you need not really worry so much about it. A vitamin called as biotin and iron tablets can take care of this hair loss, reduce this hair loss. Methotrexate fog. An occasional person experiences something called as Methotrexate fog. What is exactly Methotrexate fog? One can experience generalized weakness, headache, fatigue, heavy-headedness on the day and the day following Methotrexate intake. This is generally mild, tends to settle over a period of time. Just in case it is very troublesome and doesn't settle, then Methotrexate may have to be stopped. Methotrexate is metabolized by the liver and it can lead to rise in the liver enzymes. Liver enzymes are SGOT, SGPT blood tests that you must have seen your rheumatologist doing on a regular basis. These liver enzymes are regularly monitored. To begin with, it is done once a month, and later as the dose is stabilized, it is done once in 3 months. What is the worrisome level of rise in liver enzymes? 3 times the upper limit of normal. So suppose for SGOT, SGPT, suppose if the level normal levels are 0 to 35, then a worrisome level would mean 35 into 3. That is, anything more than 105 would be really worrisome. Methotrexate, what can be done if this happens? If the liver enzymes rise, what can be done? Methotrexate is generally stopped if liver enzymes increase, and then it is restarted in a lower dose once they normalize, and obviously it is monitored in the long run on a regular basis. It can also lead to drop in the blood counts, drop in hemoglobin, white cells, platelets. So CBC is regularly monitored the same way as SGOTPT or the liver enzymes. Initially it is done once a month, and later on, once in 3 months, methotrexate is stopped if there is a drop in the blood counts. And folic acid that is given with methotrexate generally avoids this side effect related to methotrexate. Lung inflammation with methotrexate is extremely rare. If you ever experience breathlessness, persistent dry cough, or undue fatigue while on methotrexate, do report it to your physician or rheumatologist as early as possible. Immunity suppression. Methotrexate is a immunomodulator. It suppresses the immunity. So you should be stopping it if there is any infection or fever. If there is any drop in blood cells with fever or platelets due to fever or any other reason, stop methotrexate immediately. And do consult your rheumatologist prior to any vaccination. Pregnancy and lactation. Can methotrexate be taken? No. During pregnancy, it can harm the unborn child. So, for a lady, it needs to be stopped 3 months prior to conception. Lactation, it can harm the child. Thank you, warriors, for joining me for this episode of Stand for ACE videos. Let us meet next week with another video. Till then, keep smiling. Thank you.